Ethiopia wants presidential spokesperson. Gabriel Shehu against falsehood. Guys, welcome back to our channel. How are you all doing? Happy Christmas to you and happy Sunday as well. God bless you for stopping by once again. Guys, Nigeria has become a place that falsehoods thrive so much. Falsehood progress, falsehood moves around. Everything about their information is falsehood. They keep bringing up information that is not true, whereas they are doing the real thing inside, but they will come out and present falsehood. Guys, all the presidential spokesperson, their media, whatever, and all the rest of them, there is no truth in their mouths. Do you know that when you go to abroad and you say something to any white man, they will ask you again and question you the second time? The reason they do this is not because they are not hearing you. They do it because they have seen Africans as liars. You get what I mean? An African will tell the government officials something. Do you know that government officials will secretly and quietly investigate that person and that thing? But if it happens to be white, even the fake white and the real ones, as soon as they tell them that way, they will just take it like that, line, hook and sinker. There is no investigation of whatsoever about it. You get what I mean now? So it is in the blood of Africans, especially black. That's why Mazina the Kalu keep shouting DCOG. DCOG. We have a long way to go. But anyway, in this news, before we get to the details of this news, if you've not subscribed, endeavor to do so. At least you can use that to, you know, make Christmas for this page and grow the community, which you are part of them today as you are watching. God bless you as you give us thumbs up once again. Let's get the details and hear what indigenous people of Biafra has said to Garba Shehu and its cohorts. Let's get the details. IPOP, in a statement by its spokesperson, Emma Powerful, faulted Shehu, who reportedly was of a view that the international community should declare it a terror group. The news reads in parts. The indigenous people of Biafra has called on Garba Shehu, senior special assistant on media and publicity to President Muhammadu Buhari, to moderate his campaign of calumny against the group. IPOP, in a statement by East West Person, has said to Shehu, you should refrain from persuading the international community to declare IPOP a terrorist group. The group said this in the world. Let's take that again. The group said the world did not need to be told who terrorists were, as they already know them. Are you getting it? Guys, it has been a campaign for a couple of months now that the international community should declare IPOP a terrorist group, and of which they are not. Do you get what I mean now? Of which IPOP is not a terrorist group. And the world is saying it, and the world knows how everything is moving. You get what I mean now? These people are persuading the world to declare IPOP terrorist group. But they forgot to know that the world is seeing who is who. They know who is who. Only that sometimes they are seeing their evil and they decided to sit on it because of one or two bilateral agreements and arrangements. Guys, let's continue. The statement reads, following the frustration, self-pity and clueless of an irritant presidential media aide, Garba Shehu, with the global movement of the family of indigenous people of Biafra under the command and the leadership of Liberator Mazen Nnamdi Kanu, again want to put the civilized countries on notice that Garba Shehu is displaying his annoying ignorance and by calling the international community to tag IPOP and Chero Group. We understood that Garba Shehu has been going around the world lobbying and begging them to declare IPOP terrorist group, but unfortunately for him, the world do not need to be told who the terrorists are because they already know them. Garba Shehu has been messing himself and APC administration around the world, thinking that the Western world doesn't know what IPOP stands for. Since the formation of this great movement, the world knows that IPOP is for freedom of Biafra. Fulani terror group have raised many communities in Nigeria. Today, without your government challenging them, Fulani has been the masterminder of every terrorism and its group terrorizing Nigeria. Today, IPOP operates in over 100 different countries and they know that IPOP stands for. None of those countries has ever declared us terrorists. Garba Shehu cries, cannot change their conviction about IPOP. This crocodile cry is showing the world how complicit Garba Shehu and the government are towards the plight of the citizen in the hell called Nigeria. Garba Shehu and its cohort and its co-travelers declare bandit terror group to deceive the Western world so they can declare IPOP terrorist group. Unfortunately, the Western world knows them and how we are sponsoring Fulani terrorism to declare many villages and communities, rename them Fulani name communities. Garba Shehu should, instead of move up and down to lobby for the declaration of IPOP as a terrorist group, call Western power to help organize referendum for indigenous people in Nigeria to decide where they want to be, whether in Nigeria on stand on their own or to be separated from Nigeria. He should stop making jest of himself and Fulani people in his brother Buhari's government, because the Western world knows them, then they know themselves. The truth must be set straight from today, and Biafra must be set free, because the civilized countries knows the cause of numerous deaths in Nigeria. The statement reads, in conclusion, this is Garba Shehu was spotted on interview. He is being interviewed by one of the country. He is shedding crocodile tears that the Westerners should declare IPOP terrorist group. Is that going to happen? It's not going to happen. Let him shed tears for all he likes. IPOP is not a terrorist group. They are well known. And they know Fulanis as a terror group. Leave us a comment, guys. What is your own take? How can you explain this? Let's hear from you at the comment section. I'll see you again in the next one. Bye for now.